Oh, look! Look, he's hitting the camera! Oh. He's sitting on it! He sat on top of the camera!
Here he comes! Here he comes! He's got it! Yeah! Yeah. The episode that you're about to watch, along with many hundreds more full episodes and videos to come, filmed all around the world with all different kinds of species, are all going to be available for you to watch right here for free, thanks to our mates at ITM. So, enjoy.
What we are about to embark on this week is three full-on days of fishing. A day of heli fishing, a day of deep sea fishing, and a day of inshore snapper fishing. Joining us on the trip is these fellas here. These guys are competition winners. So I hope you guys have got plenty of energy, because we've got three full-on days. We're fishing in three different ways, and we're starting on this thing here, a helicopter. So it doesn't get much better way to start a trip than on a chopper, so come on.
Because we've got a total of six lucky winners with us, we've split the guys up into two groups, and the Heliops choppers will be flying us out to two separate secret spots on the Northland coast. Justin is guiding one of the groups at a spot known as Mystery Rock. Meanwhile, me and my guys have touched down at a spot we'll call Mystery Island, and it hasn't taken long at all for the fish to show up.
Oh, look, these fish jumping around over here, Matt.
Hang on, mate, hang on. Oh, there's two sides. Did you see what they were? Oh, yeah. Oh, yes, there's fish swirling here. I can't quite make it. Oh, snapper. Yes, you're right, mate. Snapper already in the burley. Of course, first thing we do when we get to a spot is we've chucked our king salmon burley bombs in. I've got some baby salmons here too, which I'll just throw some chunks, see if I can draw these fish in, and so I can make out what they are. That one was a kahawai, but there was a snapper cruising around there before, eh? Oh, that was a snapper right on the surface. That was a snapper that broke the surface right there. Wasn't a very big one, but it was a snapper. And then look, there's kahawai there too. Hey? Not bad, eh?
Yeah.
Snapper's swimming around. We haven't even got a bait in yet, eh, bro?
Yeah.
See, oh, look at that, the snapper. See, he come right out of the water. Did you get that? That snapper came right, brought his head out of the water to eat that chunk. Watch this. Watch this. There's only a little one, but he's key. Look, snapper. Oh, look, there's a few bigger ones. Bigger snappers down lower there too. Look, snappers, 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 eh? You watch those chunks. Those snapper were breaching. Their heads were coming out of the water. I mean, you very rarely see that when you're fishing from a boat, but you come to these sort of more remote areas, the Northland coast, fish off the rocks, and this is, I hate to say, but kind of run of the mill. Though I still tend to get excited about it. Keep an eye on that, here he comes. Here comes the snapper. Ooh, he turned away, just be quiet. Don't shout, no loud noise. Ooh. Okay, another chunk there, ready? That snapper's here, two snapper there, there's two snapper eyeing it and a kahawai. Who's gonna get it? Look at them, see? They're just coming end on and looking straight down the barrel of the camera. You watch that chunk there, here he comes. Here he comes, and out of the water. That was a snapper, and right here by our feet. And we're feeding them on salmon too, so they're gonna be nice and tasty. Oh, did you see me right here? These snappers, they're just like a little pets. This is gold, isn't it? I suppose I better get some gear ready. Rightio, guys. Sure, you're very eager to get a bait in. Like, we'll start, these salmons are a decent size, so we'll start with halves. And our rig couldn't be more simple. It's a bit of 60 pound Suffolk trace. We've got a bit of 30 pound Suffolk mono line, and it's connected with a swivel. And we've just got a 7 bar O hook on the end. I just like with the head, let's go through the eye because it's a nice bony bit. Pull it right through, and then just sort of roll that hook. Now, I like to have a bit of hook showing, so when the fish comes and eats it, you're going to get a nice clean hook up. The flip side to that is if it sinks into the kelp like that, you're going to get snagged. And the way the fish are around, you're probably going to get picked up before it gets to the bottom. Give them a couple of seconds into it, and then you're on your own from there. Any more questions? Catch some fish there.
We've got plenty of snapper and kahawai in our burley, But before we throw in a bait, let's check in on Justin and the boys over at Mystery Rock.
Oh, we've let the burley work for about 20 minutes now and our first bag's almost sort of gone, so time to put out a bait and see what's out there. Yeah, just getting a few taps. Oh, whoa, whoa, oh, yep. Something's just picked me up here. Here he goes. Yeah, no, just dropped them. That was the first bait. So, that's pretty promising so far. First bait, one take. So, as soon as these other guys get some bait in the water, I think hopefully we have a good day. We'll just put a burley in here, and the first bait just got smacked by a snap, so fingers crossed, eh?
Cool.
So what we'll do is I'm just going to get another burley in, and just be careful, we've been caught by a couple of waves that have splashed up, you know, they don't look like they're coming up far, and the next minute one's up, halfway up the rock, so safety first. Burley number two. Lots of burley. Sweet. Okay, first cast, one fish, lost. Second cast, so here we go. Some hits. Are you in? You into it? Yep, let's have a look. All right, species, wrong size. Oh, your first land-based halibut caught snapper.
Thanks, Justin.
And we'll get him back. You into a fish? Whoa! Into a fish?
Yep.
Yep. Oh, he's carwhite. That's right, it's fresh bait. Yes.
Oh,
sweet.
Nothing
wrong with that. We'll keep him for some fresh baits.
Yep. Here he comes. Here he comes. He's got it. Yeah! It's a nice work, guys.
Oh, he got him on over there.
Keep him moving, Alex. That's it. Oh, it's a nice one. That'll be the fish of the day if you get him.
We hope you're enjoying this classic episode, but if you'd like to see our latest content, action, tips and how-to videos, you can get it all on the Ultimate Fishing app, available now at the App Store, Google Play, or by visiting ultimatefishing.tv.
Lift seat, high rod angle to keep him up on over that kelp. There's kahawai.
Okay, that'll do. Stop winding there, mate. Keep your rod low angle or else you might break your rod.
Oh, okay.
Okay, we'll keep that one for bait, eh?
Okay.
Unless you really want to eat it.
Nah.
Sweet. Cameraman's got it. Cameraman's got a trace for you. There's our bait as demonstrated. He's bait runners. I mean, see, this one's been around the traps for years. Real simple to use. Open the bail arm over and it's just a little underarm lob. Don't need to cast far, there's plenty just out there where it is. Heaps. And if you close that bail arm, see there's a bit of slack in the line which will give it enough to sink a bit. This lever on the bottom, that's your bait runner, which means that the line can run out freely.
Yep.
Just loosen that resistance and you'll let it run out just for a couple of seconds. Look, somebody's grabbed it now, see? Oh, let it go. You can either, as soon as you turn the handle, it engages the gears, and then you're away. That's gone down the bottom, so. No. Just, you don't want your bait sitting still for a real long time because it'll get stuck in the weeds.
Yep.
You can give it a slight wind in to move it up at the bottom, but then once you've moved it, yeah, you've got to flick your bait runner back on, okay? Get ready? Okay, flick your bait runner on, give it a wind, strike. Yeah, you got it, mate. And that's how the system works in full effect. Oh yeah, little snapper. There we go. Oh, that's not bad actually.
Yeah.
It's an eater. See the dark kelp colours on him?
Yep.
Oh, our man over here is into it. Look at it, get into it, mate, don't be shy. That's it, mate. Oh, yeah, go. Oh, hauling them in. Then we're going to keep up with these guys. Okay. Well, what do you reckon, just for good karma's sake, we let our first snapper go, eh?
Yeah, yeah.
Judging by these ones swimming around here, that there's plenty more where this fella come from.
Where you go, buddy?
Go on, get down there, get down there, get down there. Good boy. Look at that, straight into the burley trout, carries on feeding. There was a quite annoyed snapper, literally sucking on our burley bag right here. Look at the kahawa as well. Oh, no rest for the wicket, eh? Oh, no, don't strike, mate. Oh, look what Ian done. No, you don't strike until it's till the gears engaged, mate. I'll sort that out for you, hang on. Okay, one handle. Yeah, okay, do that before you strike.
Oh, wind the handle.
Yeah, bro, yeah. Okay, oh, geez, you got smashed when you wanted to do it. They're everywhere. That's a joke. Oh, look at them. Hey guys, you're casting too far. I'm touching the snapper with the camera. I just bumped the camera, snapper with the camera. Oh, look, he's hitting the camera. Oh. He's sitting on the... He sat on top of the camera. Oh. The snapper came to eat my little camera. Look, he's right on it.
Must be the orange.
Yeah, watch that. Oh, no, you got the car. Why grab your bait? I've read a few articles about guys stealthing around the rocks wearing camouflage gear, whispering to each other, casting from behind a rock, because snapper are so sensitive. Are you guys sensitive? No, they're right there, look at that. He's actually right on the camera now. He's right there. That is sick. I'm touching them with this little camera that we've got here. I could just as easily scoop one out of the water with a net or a gaff. That wouldn't be sport, would it? Snapper, is it?
Yeah.
All right, one?
Oh, yeah, it's a nice one.
Take your time, mate. Take your time. We'll slide them up, buddy. Just don't lift them too high, though. Good work, mate.
Just wrapped. I never caught a snapper this big in my whole life.
Haven't you caught a snapper that big before?
Not where we rode them this week.
Geez, you're in for a treat then, mate. Good work. Oh, that's a keeper, boys. We're on the board.
Oh, that's a nice one.
Whoa. Wonder how those other fellas are getting on.
I've just got a big slab of kawa, that fresh kawa we caught earlier. I've literally just taken one fillet straight down the middle, skin off, so it's a good bait at the moment. So hopefully if something picks it up, it'll be a goodie.
That was a goodie.
Oh, the fish size is getting a little bit bigger. She's starting to heat up all of a sudden. Oh, it's a goodie.
Ah, come on, baby.
Oh, yeah. Gotcha.
No.
He's having a swim out.
Excellent size. Bad for a bad time on the rocks.
Oh, this on pulls on a good start, eh? Good start. Yeah, it was a good runner, mate. Went straight into the weed, eh? Now, I've gone for the cameraman's recommendation. I asked him, I said, what sort of bait next? And this is what he suggested, so I'm going to go with his theory on that one. Watch him, I try a bigger bait next time. Oh, that's the one. He's stroking him.
Hey, Curly.
Oh, righto, my turn. Yep, you got one. Oh! Oh! He got the big bust off. Go look back at the camera and tell us how that felt. Oh, we've been here for about an hour. We were dropped off on a remote part of the northern east coast by our heli ops, and we've only been here about an hour, but the burley started working so far, and we've had plenty of snapper coming on board.
Oh,
missed him? Oh yeah. Nice. Oh yeah.
Nice.
Nice. Oh yeah. It doesn't feel big enough to have swallowed that whole bit of carb. There he is. Hey, he took it with some passion. Yep. Oh, he's a dark red one, so at least he's the right colour. That just shows you, wasn't quite the 20 odd pounder I was after with a whole, you know, with a half car wide, but shows you the size of the fish that will grab big baits. So don't be scared of putting big baits out.
Oh, look at that clear water. Just when that water oils off like that, you can just see those snappers. Just all crowding around that belly pot. You know, we've been here almost an hour now, I haven't put a bait in because this is just so awesome. For those of you that aren't familiar with snapper, they are New Zealand's iconic fish, and it's widely regarded that they're a very shy and timid fish, and to see one in the wild, even when you're in the water scuba diving, is very rare. So this really is a treat. Oh, that's a nice snapper, boy. That's a nice snapper. Don't lift his head out. Just keep his head up above that kelp. I'll come give you a hand. Okay, it's a nice one, buddy.
Oh, that's a nice one.
Okay, just nice and smooth. See this gutter over here?
Yep.
That's where you want to land them, somewhere low. Guide them over, just watch this, yep. Don't lift his head out too high. Just wait for a wave and we wash him up. See, wave comes up, wash him into the gutter, just like that. Wash him up, nice work.
Well done, mate.
Nice work, that's a nice one. So that'll have to be a personal best then?
Definitely.
Well, if your last one was, that one's bigger. Mate, this is all good. And of course, this is just the snapper that we can see. You can imagine, as that burley's dispersing out around the edge, guys are hooked up again. It's going to be full on morning. There's bigger ones just lurking beyond. Keep them up, mate. You got to look like you got to. Come on, we've got to go. See this, fellas. Okay, we've got 3 days. We're doing it in 3 ways. And you fellas, but no, don't lift them. Just see that gutter over there? Use that to wash them up. That's where you break your line. Fishermen get that rush of excitement when they see that fish and they go, I want it, and they rush the last few minutes. Use the swell, and when the swell goes back, he'll be right there, see?
Oh,
okay, use the swell.
Yeah.
Okay, you fellas can look after those fish. Beautiful. Oh, look, there's a few bigger ones. Bigger snappers down lower there, too.
Here he comes. He's got it, yes!
Oh, look what he has done! This will be a good lesson, not just for you, but for everyone watching. A snapper just came up and grabbed your bait off the surface, and what did you do? Pulled your rod straight away. He had no chance to eat it. Look at your hook, it's empty. You just ripped the bait off your hook, swam away, he's laughing. Get him back, don't let him get the last laugh.
I'll get him back.
That away, my mate. That's what that bait runner's for, mate, just to give them a bit of a chance to grab it, turn, and when you see him turn and swim away, and it is not normal, by the way, to see your snapper take your bait, turn and swim away. But when you do see him turn and swim away, that's just when you click it into gear, come tight, and you'll hook him in the mouth, mate. And it'll give you, it is an amazing treat to be able to actually see what's going on here. It gives you a great understanding. All those times in the boat, you feel a bite. Well, right here, you can actually see your bite and see what's going on. And look at these two. Oh, there's a nice one here now, boys. I wanted to catch that one. I might have to catch him.
I'm chomping at the bit to present a bait to one of these snapper, but that's going to have to wait till next week when the action gets hotter and the fish get bigger.
Let me pick my bait up.
There we go, bait. Snapper, yee-haw! For our Hunting and Fishing New Zealand tackle tip this week, I just want to talk about some of the things that you should look for when choosing a place to go rock fishing. Obviously something like this where there's deep water close by, but there's also nice shallow areas with kelp because that's where all the food is. And it's all very well having that, but if you can't safely fish from it, and by that I mean if there's too many big swells coming in or if there's steep bluffs, just rule it out, you can't fish there. Here you'll see we've got a nice sloping access down to the water, which makes it nice and easy to wash up our snapper and land them.
We hope you enjoyed this classic episode, but if you want to see the latest and greatest stuff from all around the world, you can get it all for free at ultimatefishing.tv or by downloading the Ultimate Fishing app.